Here we are again.
Oh no, little Miss Karkan.
Anyway, congrats Tarjay on winning the first sing-off.
Thank you so much, Karatina.
I am happy that Tarjay stayed and Karkan went home. Honestly, Karkan was annoying with her negativity and her nonchalant attitude about the competition. Bye, Felicia.
It was nerve-wracking to see Tarjay on the bottom. She is one of the first people that I got close with.
I was honestly shook about the results, that Peppa should have packed her bags and went back to the slaughterhouse.
Okay, so where is the wine? I want to celebrate my win. Oh my god, I won the first challenge of season. I'm so happy I left my mark right at the beginning of the competition and I hope I can keep this positive mindset going.
I'm honestly shocked. What? The hell? I would have been on the top if Miss Greta Grenfell hadn't stolen my song. Honestly, really rude, and I won't stand for this. I am after her ass and I want her to be sent packing. I did not deserve to be bottom three. At all.
The winner of Daniel's song race receives a 1-year supply of Forum Fame. And a cash prize of $1.
Today is a new day in the workroom, and it smells like bacon in here. I know it's haram, but I want to eat it.
I've noticed Greta looking at me a lot, like she wants something. It's strange that every time I look at her, she winks at me.
Now don't go telling everyone, but damn, I have the hots for Karatina. What a sexy little lesbian. Can't wait to put her in my fanny.
Every story has two sides. And now it's your time to tell them. Let your voice be heard, and don't forget that it takes two to make a thing go right.
Oh no, not a pair challenge.
Hello. Ladies, for this week's challenge, you will have to work in pairs.
A pair challenge? I definitely do not want to be paired with at least half of these bitches.
I have decided that you may choose the pairs by yourselves. As for the challenge, each pair will have to send two songs with the exact same title.
Is it okay if we send-
I said the exact same title, no excuses. Well ladies, I'll leave the pairing to you now. Good luck, and don't fuck it up guys. See you later.
This week's main challenge is to get into pairs and find two songs with the same title. I wanted to find a partner that is unique and easy to work with, so I chose Queen Sayonara. She is fierce, funny and that waist is crazy. I think we will pick fierce songs for the competition.
I see everyone quickly teaming up and I'm one of the last ones left. Looking at who's left, I have to say. Not a lot of good choices. So I ended up pairing with Peppa, who was in the bottom three last week. Hopefully this won't hurt me.
While all teams were preparing themselves for the challenge, Greta and Poonanny showed no sign of working on it. Girl, I know Grandma is slow but if they don't step it up, it will be Ohana. Which means pack your bags and sashay away.
Hello. Team Tarjay Greece, how are you? So Tarjay, you have been in the bottom last week.
Yes.
Did you learn anything from your mistakes?
It's time to step out of my comfort zone and go for something completely different.
Ketchup, you have been safe. How are you making sure to stand out?
Well, experimental is what we're going for. Our title choice is pussy, which leaves lots of room for your interpretation.
What is your main focus with your songs this week?
Well, since we get to send two songs of the same title, we are trying to focus on how different the songs are.
Alright, I'm hoping the best for you. See you on the main stage. Team Queen Carrot.
Hi Daniel.
Hey Mama.
Why did you choose each other as partners?
I chose Karatina because she seems like a girl with spice and I thought we would make a great team.
I think we can truly make magic.
What is your strategy for this challenge?
We wanted to find songs that represented us as people. We are unique and different and we chose songs that demonstrate that difference.
I see. Well, which team do you think is the biggest competition?
I think the team of Evocado and Lucy for our competition, but I'm confident that our songs are fierce and you will love them.
Sounds great. Can't wait to see what you will bring to the stage. Bye, girls. Greta Grenfell and Miss Poonani, how did you girls get together? You're quite a weird pairing.
Well, we kind of were the leftovers, so we had no other chance, really.
Have you looked for any songs yet?
I mean, yeah, sure. We did. Greta falls asleep a lot, but we're doing okay.
Excuse me, young lady. I am wide awake.
I don't think Greta and Panini have much of a chance. They don't have much chemistry. Or talent.
Alright, girls. I am sure you can pull it off. See you out there. Ladies, listen up. Additional to our new set of judges, this week, we'll have a guest judge returning. It is Miss Kathleen Slater. So make sure to bring it, you slags. Bye-bye. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to episode 2 of Daniel's Song Race, season 7. This week, we have an extra special guest judge, Kat Slater.
I didn't become a little bit of a slag. I became a total slag.
Welcome back, girl. This week, we asked our queens to work in pairs and send two different songs with the exact same title. Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines. And may the best song win.
What doesn't kill us makes us stranger. So don't be a stranger. Don't be a stranger. Yeah. Don't be a stranger.
Still, I think that we'll survive if I can wait until.
Welcome back, ladies. This week you had to work together as pairs, but you will be judged individually. If I call your name, you may please step forward. Queen Say and Yara. Tez Harari. Maya West. Holly Glamorous. Ketchup Grease. Lucifer. Peppa Pills. You are all safe. You may leave the stage. It is now time for the judges' critiques. Let's start with the Carrot Dards.
Overall, my favorite team this week as a whole, your songs matched really well. This song is the better one, so crispy and fresh, always a fan of male vocals. Amazing job, sweetie.
One of the best team this week, both of you served really good yet different songs. And Carrot Tards, you did not disappoint yet again.
Okay, so, I don't agree with the other judges. I'm not really vibing with this. Like, it's an alright song, but I never want to listen to it again. It's just so pretentious. But as a team, y'all were cute and diverse, but not really memorable.
Moving on to the great Greta Grinful.
Hello there.
This is a masterpiece and really spoke to me, because I relate. Y'all really snapped there in team I'm in love.
I love how you're trying to show that you're down, cool and hip with the kids, but that's my job. You truly showed us what is wrong with dating culture today, but the challenge wasn't social justice week. Aim higher.
Oh, okay.
Next up is Alana Coke.
This was a nice one-time listen, but it didn't do anything for me otherwise really. I don't feel like this stood out in the crowd at all, which when there are so many of you, might be okay, but it's definitely something to consider in future weeks.
Hi my dear, welcome to your first critique. You didn't send the worst song this week, but it failed to excite me. You just didn't have anything positive going for you. I think your teammate did a much better job than you this week. And to have Dreams as your song title, I mean really. How much easier can it get than that?
Moving on to Caro Tina.
My least favorite team of the week, though I'm happy you both had fun working together, which is always more important than the result. The song itself is fine, it just did not stand out as much. I'm sorry.
Look at Rebelm Grebelk. I can't deal. This is not good. This is just a really not good song. I have nothing nice to say about this, I'm so sorry. It's so bland, it's borderline irritating, and devoid of all personality.
Girl, were you hungry when you chose this? This song is a dirge, plain and simple. The production fails to impress me in the slightest. Let's hope you manage to find a better producer for next week, if you are still here.
Next up, Darjay Fable.
Wow, what a turnaround from you this week. Last week made me want to run to the toilet, but this time you're making me book a one-way ticket to migrate to Finland, legally.
Wow girl, you bounce back even better than my boobs. This song went off so hard I don't have any complaints. Definitely a standout entry this week, brilliant.
You really snapped this week. Thank you for proving you were the right one to stay last week. Thank you all so much for your kind words.
Punani is up next.
Hello, hello.
A bit unoriginal for my taste, not the sound, but the fact that this panel has already heard this song before. Love that you went with two different genres in your team, you're very versatile.
Maybe not the most original song choice, but it's a fun song and I liked the slightly more creative approach to the theme.
I'm in love. This is just a really cute, refreshing bop. Like, if you say something negative about this song you are probably going to hell, and you really can't say anything negative about this song.
Thanks a lot.
And last in the line is Eve the Cotto.
I was really into this song. I don't think I liked it as much as I initially thought I was going to, but I still really enjoyed it. It's definitely one of the standouts for me personally.
This song isn't a half love, it's a whole love. Definitely my favorite of this week. It especially stands out compared to your chosen partner. Great job, please continue like this, Eva.
I don't know what these judges are on, but I'm pretty sure it's illegal, and if it's not, it should be. I'd believe you if you told me that you went into a coma this week and woke up 5 minutes ago. I'm not sorry to say this, It's one of the worst songs I've ever heard in any season of this show.
Well, thank you, ladies. While you untuck backstage, the judges and I will deliberate. Well, just between us slags, what did you think about tonight's performances, starting with the Carrot Dards?
I liked this song. It's pretty solid, a nice listen. Though, if I'm being honest, this felt like a little bit of a weird choice.
I don't understand how we're awarding such mediocrity, but here we are. Not the worst song ever, but it didn't interest me at all, no matter how white the singer is. That's all, next.
Greta Grenfell.
The song itself worked for me. I love the song and it is very catchy. However, the song title itself is a bit bland and quite a lot of songs could have been sent for the same title.
The songs felt risky and maybe they didn't completely hit the mark, but I definitely found myself enjoying them.
I've a feeling she didn't vote for me at the last election, and for that reason I think she deserves to go home, if all we're going from her is boring rap.
Alana Coke.
Exactly my kind of jam, unlike last week's failed attempt. The dreamy vocals and instruments, such a gorgeous, underestimated tune.
I love a slow bop, but this was just boring, repetitive, and I didn't care for this at all. As a team, it's bad. This was a really unmemorable week, and they were the most unmemorable. We dream in ZZZZZZZ.
Dull and dry, I didn't feel inspired at all. She better have something up her sleeve.
Caratina.
Veganism can choke. Her song sounds like something you get at the discount pile in Target. Yuck.
Team Stranger was strange. Just really strange. Strange can be good, but this was not a good kind of strange. I'm gonna be using cucumbers instead of carrots from now on.
Dargier Fable.
This is way, way better than last week. This is a world record leap, right there.
Overall, I really liked what this team went for, and even though I liked one song a lot more than the other, I liked the contrast in languages and message.
Catsup Grease has been a great teammate, and though I preferred her entry, I feel as if she pushed Dargay to do better than herself.
Punani.
This smashed my groceries and scrambled my eggs, Henny. The best team, by far. We've decided to stand eternally.
I'd prefer not to comment on her here as I don't have much to say. She's been sending some intriguing songs. Cute.
Avocado.
I might not be able to answer if the love is half full or half empty, but I for sure know this left my pussy full.
This duo did really well. I can't really say I strongly preferred one song over the other, and both songs were great. Loved the interpretation of the theme that was a bit different. I have no complaints.
The level of professionalism. I'm eager to see more from Eva. She's one to watch out for.
All right, silence. I think we've heard enough. Bring back my girls. Welcome back, ladies. I have made some decisions. Avocado. You are safe. The Carrot Dards. You're safe. Punani. Well done. You're safe. Dargier Fable. You gave us your pussy and we ate it up. Congratulations, you're the winner of this week's challenge. You've won a trip for two to North Sentinel Island.
I'm in complete shock. I can't believe I just won a challenge.
You may leave the stage. Alana Coke, your dream made the judges fall asleep. Greta Grenfell, as a seasoned queen, you did not pull off a modern performance. Carotina, the judges did not love your presentation this week. Alana Coke, you're safe. Carotina, Greta Grenfell. I'm sorry, my dears, but you were both up for elimination.
I'm in the bottom too? I'm not going home to that old slag.
Two queens, stand before me. You were asked to prepare a sing-off for the category 70s. This is your last chance to impress me and save yourselves from elimination. the time has come for you to sing it for your life. Good luck, and don't fuck it up. Thank you, ladies. I have made my decision. Karatina. Shantae, you stay. Greta, you have proven to us that age is just a number. You will forever be remembered. But now, sashay away.
Thank you, Daniel. I will miss you all. I am sad to go, now that the sparks flew between Karatina and me. I will miss her. You young queens better be aware of Miss Greta Grainfall.